I know for a fact, since being a pastor, I've probably gone out of my way in a myriad of different issues to make people feel more comfortable, to make people feel like, sure, hey, we want you to be around. And it's like that, you know, that age old, like, hey, I've got really good intentions, but like, I don't change people, Jesus does. So if I can just keep them around long enough, like if I can just get them in the environment, eventually, you know, 3, 6, 9 months, a year down the road, Holy Spirit will take care of whatever needs to be taken care of, which in one instance is true. But I also know that like, that's not how my discipleship has looked like.
Exactly.
Like the Holy Spirit didn't just go, okay, Michael, this thing that you, this thing in your heart that is sin, like 9 times out of 10, that's somebody who I'm walking with Christ with,
right,
kind of correcting that, yeah, right? So it's like, maybe we are doing people a disservice by just saying like, oh, the Holy Spirit will deal with that.
Right.
When maybe it's more of our job, not just as pastors, but as like Christians, to walk with each other and that stuff.
I couldn't agree with you more. Yeah.
Yeah, it's awesome.
Mm-hmm. I think the way the Holy Spirit often does that is through the scriptures.
Mm-hmm.
And the scriptures have to be read and they have to be understood and they have to be taught. And so Christian, emphasis on Christian experience without Christian intellectualism, I think can lead to like high hopes and low returns.
Mm.
But when the Spirit and the Word come together and they work with one another like they're meant to,
mm-hmm,
then I think really beautiful outcomes can happen in people's lives.
Mm-hmm.